Hello everyone, in this video I am explaining introduction of digital image processing, or you can say image fundamentals. Now what is digital image processing? You can see here the block diagram in which what is given, this is image, that is a 3D world around us. The image of this scene or 3D world is captured by this camera and then it is given to digital image processing system. So what this system does, it will process this image. It may be anything. It may be cropping of image. It may be blurring the image, enhancing image, sharpening, any activity. So here it is shown that it is a cropped image and that is known as processed image. So this is a complete digital image processing system. What is image? Image is a visual representation of something. Image is a picture that can be created, copied, or stored in electronic form. So remember, image is a visual representation of something and it is stored in an electronic form. Image may be of any person, it may be any animal or scene around us or any object. So image may be anything, whatever exists around us. Now, what is image acquisition process? Now, suppose this is any object available around us and this is a light source. Light source may be your simple light or it may be sunlight, anything. So what happens when light falls on the object, this object will reflect that light. And what camera does, imaging system is nothing but camera. What camera does, camera will receive this reflection and it will create an image. So this is image, exactly similar to this object. And what is this? This is a digitized image. So you can see here, this is digitized image, which can be seen in the form of exact pixels. Now, how to represent digital image? Digital image is represented as M by N numerical array. It is represented as a function of x, y. What is x? X is nothing but number of rows and y is nothing but number of columns. So what is x and y? X represents row number and y represents column number. So what is this F00? So F00 represents row number 0 and column number 0. What this pixel represents? So this is row number 0. And column number 1. What this pixel represent? This is row number 0 and column number 2. This pixel represents row number 1 and column number 0. This pixel represents row number 2, column number 0. And this particular pixel represents row number 2 and column number 3. So what these numbers represents in the bracket that represent the row number and this represents column number. Now, how to represent digital image in the form of matrix? Actually, images are represented as pixel intensity level in the matrix. So it can be anything. You can write F of x, y, or you can represent matrix by any alphabet. Suppose it is given A is equal to this matrix. So what is this A00 represents? A00 represents pixel intensity level, which is in 0th row and 0th column. What is this? This is a pixel intensity level of a pixel that is available in 0th row and 0th column. That means this is pixel intensity of this particular pixel. This is a value of pixel intensity. Now in gray image, if number of gray levels are 256 in a gray image, let's assume that the total number of gray intensity levels used in the image are 256, then pixel intensity values will vary from 0 to 255. Total gray levels are 256. So obviously, since we are starting with 0, so pixel intensity values will vary from 0 to 255, wherein 0 represents perfect black pixel and 255 represents perfect white pixel. 0 represent perfect black pixel and 255 represent perfect white pixel. You can see that in this digital image, all these pixels, whatever are there around this image, are all white pixels. So all these pixels are white pixels. So what is the value of these pixels? The value of this pixel intensity should be 255, because this is the highest pixel intensity for white pixel. Now you can see here, this is a little blackish pixel, which is very close to black color, but it is not exactly black, and its pixel intensity may be 9 or so. So 9 is the pixel intensity of this pixel. Now if you see these pixels are very close to white, but not exactly white. These 4 pixels, these are very close to white, but not exactly white. So here pixel intensity of this pixel may be 200. That means closer to this 255, because 255 represents perfect white. This is very close to white, and hence it is 200. So what if image is represented in the form, remember, if image is represented in the form of matrix, then the values in the matrix represent pixel intensity values in that particular row, in a particular column. Now you can see here, this is a perfect gray level, and it is value maybe 127. Now representing digital images with pixel intensity values. Now let's see same image. You can see here all these pixels all around, all these pixels are white pixels, and hence all these pixels are represented as this is your n axis, this is your m axis. M is number of rows, n is number of columns, and you can see here all these white pixels are represented by 255. All these white pixels are represented by value 255. Now this is very close to black, so here it is represented by 9, not 0. This is slightly lighter than this black, so its value is 15. You can see here these are gray, perfect gray colors, so it is 127. That means middle value of 0 and 255, and you can see here these middle values, and this image can be represented like this. Digital image is represented by values, this pixel intensity values. This is our same image, you can see the shape. Now digital image, it is a two-dimensional function. This is just a revision represented by f of x comma y, where x and y are spatial coordinates. X and y are coordinates of image. What is pixel? Pixel is the element of digital image. What is pixel? Pixel is element of digital image. What is digital image processing then? Digital image processing is the use of digital computer. What is digital image processing? It is the use of digital computer to process digital image through an algorithm. That means for digital image processing, we have to use computer and we have to use algorithm. So algorithm is very, very important in digital image processing. Now in the earlier slide, I said that if number of total gray levels are 256, then pixel intensity values varies from 0 to 255, wherein 0 represents perfect black and 255 represents perfect white. But it is not necessary that always image will contain all 256 gray levels. It may use only 32 gray levels. It may use only 2 gray levels. Now here in this image, you can see that only there are 2 gray levels, that is black and white. And if there are only 2 gray levels, then how many bits are required to represent this pixel intensity values? We need only 1 bit. That means 0, 0, this 0 will indicate perfect black, and here 1 represents perfect white. That's it. Only 2 levels are required. Only 1 bit is required. 0 will indicate perfect black and 1 will indicate perfect white. Now here, how many gray levels are there? There are 32 gray levels. If there are 32 gray levels, then how many bits are required to represent 32 gray levels? So we need 5 bits to represent 32 levels. That means 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0. This will represent perfect black and all 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 will represent perfect white. Similarly, if there are 256 gray levels, how many bits are required to represent each gray level? So 8 bits are required to represent each gray level. So if we increase the number of gray levels required in the image, in that case, the number of bits required to represent will also increase, and that will increase the memory size required to store the image. So we have to choose between the quality of image, because if we use lesser number of gray levels, the quality of image will deteriorate. Now, what is image processing? Image processing operation typically defines a new image G. Image processing is, we get a new image G with coordinates X, Y. What is this F, X, Y? It is original image, and T is the transformation function. Transformation function may be anything. It may be adding some value to every pixel intensity. It may be subtracting some value from every pixel intensity. Transformation function may be anything. It may be sharpening of image. It may be cropping. It may be blurring the image. It may be adding the noise, removing the noise. So this T represents transformation function, wherein this is your output image and this is your input image. So image processing operation typically defines a new image G in terms of existing image F. Now, what is digital image processing? There are three levels of digital image processing: low level process, mid level process and high level process. Right now you will not be able to understand what is high level process. Right now just understand low level process. In low level process, input is also image and output will also image. Like example, noise removal. If in image suppose there is some noise, then if you remove that noise, then output will be also image. Or image sharpening. So you people all, you keep doing image sharpening in mobile apps, and image sharpening is an example of image processing in which you get image as output. Now, middle level process. In mid level process, input is image, but output is attributes. Here it is given example of object recognition. Suppose we have some image in which there is a cat is available. And suppose we are able to extract, or we want to extract only that cat from the entire scene, then it is known as object recognition. Or suppose there is any object, say the specs, suppose this is a image, and in this spec is there, and suppose we want to extract only this spec in the image, then it is said that it is object recognition. So here output is attribute. Now, high level process, the input is also attribute and output is understanding. So right now it is very difficult to make you understand. Just understand what is low level process and mid level process. Now, key stages in digital image processing. So digital image processing can increase the visibility of this blur image. It can increase the contrast. It can reduce the noise. So digital image processing has various steps, that is image acquisition, image enhancement, image restoration, morphological processing, segmentation, object recognition, representation and description, image compression and digital image processing. So these are all steps of digital image processing, and we have to learn all these processes in detail. Now let's understand what are the different steps of digital image processing. So it starts with image acquisition. As I explained you earlier also, if this is object and if this is a source of light, so whenever some source of light falls on the object, then this object always reflects the lights, and what camera does, camera will capture that reflection and it will generate this image. And for digital image processing, by using computer, we digitize this image and we get this digital image. What is this? This process is known as image acquisition. Image acquisition means acquiring the image. Now next is image enhancement. What happens in image enhancement? You can see here, this is image. This image is very, very dull. The colors are dull. And after image enhancement, we can get a very clear and enhanced image. So we have to learn various techniques or various algorithms of image enhancement in coming chapters. So this is known as image enhancement. Now next is image restoration. Suppose by chance we are not able to take a proper image, and if image is something like this, and suppose we want to restore that image. So image restoration is possible by using different algorithms. So this is known as image restoration. Next is morphological processing. Morphological processing works on edges and lines. You can see that this is a fingerprint of thumb, and this particular finger, these lines are extracted from the fingerprint, and that is known as morphological processing. Next is segmentation. In segmentation, what we do, we segment the image into different colors, or maybe we segment the image into different objects. Suppose there are different shape objects, then we can separate them by using segmentation. If there are different colors, then we can separate them by using segmentation. So various segmentation algorithms are available. So this is image segmentation. Next is object recognition. Object recognition is used in artificial intelligence or machine learning. Now suppose this is machine, and we are continuously telling this machine that this is cat, this is cat, this is cat. And we are telling it that this is dog, this is dog, this is dog. And whenever we give, suppose here we apply a dog picture at the input of this object recognition algorithm, then it should understand that whether it is a cat or dog based on whatever data we have applied earlier. So recognizing object is known as object recognition. Next is representation and description. So it is just the representation and description is nothing but just extracting the boundaries of object. Suppose this is object, and suppose we want to extract the boundaries of the object, then various algorithms are available for extracting the boundaries. Next is image compression. We know that to make it store in a smaller space, if there is a limitation of the memory, we always compress the image. Like JPEG format. JPEG format is a compression format. So various image compression techniques are available by which we can compress the image. So before transmission, we have to compress, and then at the receiver end, then again it can decompress and get the original image back. And last is color image processing. So whenever we do all this, whenever we apply all image processing techniques, like image enhancement, restoration, morphological, segmentation, object recognition, representation, or image compression on color images, then it is said that it is color image processing. So these are the key stages of any digital image processing. You can say these are the key stages in digital image processing. And we have to learn all these techniques one by one in detail by using different algorithms. So this was just a basic concept of image fundamentals or basics of image digital image processing. So I hope you understood. If you have any doubt, you can always ask in the comment section. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.